Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory on a Thursday afternoon, and we decided to go ahead and start working on this chassis, which as promised, we had talked about doing a little bit of dry brushing to bring out the details. Now, before I tell you, the tools, and it's very easy. It has a long history in all aspects of the model building hobby. Military builders, everybody sooner or later learns to do dry brushing. It a little bit goes a long ways. And so the other thing that I was going to say is that you could try all kinds of combinations of colors. You could do brass, any kind of metalizer paint that you can try. For example, this could be flat red, and then you can come in with brass and or gold, copper, anything, and it would make the detail stand out. In this case, though, we are going to go with the semi-gloss black that we have on there, and then probably a little bit of silver. And I think this is a little bit of gunmetal. So I want to try, I want to start with the gunmetal a little bit, just in case I'm going to cover up some, I like that hand action, it's like, oh, just in case, woohoo, abracadabra. And again, I was going to say, just in case we mess up, but there's really no way to mess this up. The important tools here are a variety of brushes that you designate for dry brushing. I kind of like this one here. We're going to go with this one, in part because what you want is very little paint. Well, you'll see. But again, depending on the size of the job, you can get a flat, an angled brush like this would be fine too. So just have a few handy. I think we're going to go with this big boy here. This is a 10. 3/8, something like that. I have no idea what any of that means, but we're also shaking up our paint. I haven't done one of these in quite a while. I feel so so brand new and refreshed. And then we are gonna, of course, put just a little bit on there. All you really need is a drop. Very important though, it has to be a dry brush, right? You have to begin with a dry brush. And then, of course, you're picking it up, and the way to test it is on the napkin, right? And you just make sure you're picking up a little bit of it. And so now we are going to begin. Let's see where. Let's begin here with the rear suspension, and again, just a little goes a long ways. Also, with our friendly gas tank. It's already picking it up very quickly. Let me see if you can. You probably don't see it that well. Again, the reason for the gunmetal is that it's a little bit darker, and you can come back in, and let's see. We'll do that. We'll do these marks. Once you load up the paint, you will find that a little goes a long ways. And you probably won't need to, add any more to the brush. A little bit, again, a little bit goes a long ways. How many times can we say that? Never get tired. And it picks up all of the relieved detail, right? And, what we like about this is just that, with a simple technique like this, you can make your model stand out. With very little effort, and again, goes a long ways. I don't know. I can see it. I don't know if you can see it. But anyway, that's basically the process. You're just going around. Notice I haven't done now. If you, for whatever reasons, you start to run low, just go back in there and rub the brush back and forth, making sure you don't have, it appears initially that you don't have anything on it. But trust me, you have a lot of that silver paint gunmetal on the brush. And so come around all the edges, right? If you want the edges to catch, right? In here, we're going up and down, we're going sideways, and it's just, you know, it's just actually very, very relaxing too. Woo! Maybe I should open a dry brushing center and get arrested for, you know, a lot of illegal dry brushing. Now, at that point, I have plenty, right? I mean, I can do some of the wheel wells and all of that. I'm not doing the other side because, you know, why? So we've got the you know, the gunmetal out of the way. I am going to actually put a little bit of this. Oh, wow, we're already at 6 minutes. I'm going to put a little bit of that bright silver, kind of aluminum-ish. And once again, dry brush. Now you're picking up a lot of the paint. Make sure that you remove most of it, right? Just remove most of it, and then we're going to come back in, and very gently, once again. Oh yeah, the silver is picking up even more of the details. The bolts, the anything that's relieved is gonna pick it up and do its job. So we're liking that. Woo, go. Again, there's no method to the madness. You'll find your own way and you'll figure out exactly what works for you and what doesn't work for you. This actually is working very well for me right now. So I'm just gonna hit up some of the edges in the front here and call it a day. So that's pretty much dry brushing in a nutshell. And that's it. That's pretty much it. I think you can see it catching the light there, right? So, and this is a technique that you can use to weather your vehicles. You can flow inks later, do all kinds of washes. You could add, you know, variety of color here and there. It's up to you, and the possibilities are endless. So take your time, enjoy the process, and as you saw there, you can get a lot done in a short 8 minutes. All right, my friends, stay tuned in for more Cranky Show coming right up.